Hi everyone, in this video I am going to talk to you about how we're going to communicate during class. So this semester I would like to use Zoom team chat instead of using email or Canvas inbox. So I prefer that all our communication happens in one tool, and this summer it's just going to be Zoom. So you can think of Zoom as just a meeting place, but actually Zoom has a very powerful team chat feature. Just like you would think of WhatsApp or Discord, something like that, Zoom also has. And the good news is that you're going to need to use the Zoom app anyway for my class, because you're going to be joining my exam Zoom meetings, and also if you need to join my office hours. So you will not need to download another app, such as, for example, Slack or whatever. We're going to be just using Zoom and the team chat feature. So I'm going to introduce the team chat feature right now. And before I get going, just want to make sure, if you want to contact me, please do not send me an email or Canvas inbox. I will usually answer you in Zoom team chat to force you to use it, because I would like everybody to use just one tool, and I find it is much better than Canvas. It also helps me stay organized. It has a lot of features such as reminders and notifications that I can use so that I can work productively and efficiently. Okay, so let's just say that you want to, for the first time, use a Zoom team chat. Let me introduce what you will need to do. So number one, you're gonna need to download Zoom desktop to your computer, and also download Zoom app on your phone, okay? Now on the phone, maybe you already have it. If you don't, just go to App Store or Play Store and download the app. On the computer, in the search, Google search, you're just gonna say Zoom download. Okay, and then you will download it depending on your machine, on Windows or Mac. Now that you downloaded it, you will see it on the bottom over here. So I'll click on it, and now it's called Zoom Workspace. So it looks like this. If it is on your phone, it'll look exactly the same. So this is my phone I'm projecting right now, and you want to click on sign in. So I click on sign in. Now, it's not showing me anything because it's blocking the by security, but it, let me show you what it'll look like. It's something like this. And the option you want is called SSO. So on your phone, it may look a little bit different. Maybe it's all vertical, but you want to look for the all the way to the bottom, somewhere on the bottom, it'll say SSO, okay? So I don't know if I have a screenshot to show you, maybe. Well, I don't think I do, but it's right here, okay? So you click on SSO, it's gonna ask you, what is your company domain? The company domain for us is Palm Beach State. It's one word. And you will only have to enter it usually one time, because it's just gonna remember it next time. So like, for example, if I click on SSO, because I already did it multiple times, it's gonna remember it's Palm Beach State. Okay, so just one word, Palm Beach State. Then it'll take you to Authenticator, where you're gonna enter your username and password, your PBSC username and password, and it's gonna connect you, okay? So once you download it, it'll look something like this, which may be something you're already familiar with if you use Zoom already on your computer. But what the feature I'm talking about in order for us to collaborate is something called Team Chat. So it's over here, Team Chat on the top. Okay, it looks something like this. Now on the phone, I also want to show you where it said, if I were to log in on my phone, where is the Team Chat? Okay, so let me show you. This is my phone, so the Team Chat is on the bottom here. So it would be like right here. You see what I'm showing you? And now I can see all the channels and everybody at Palm Beach State. I can contact them, okay? So let's just say this is the first time I'm using Team Chat. You want to join our channel. So I created a channel for each class that I'm teaching, and you need to join the right one. But don't worry, if you join the wrong one, I can actually move you to the right one if you didn't know which one. So you're gonna go to the plus sign over here. Now on the phone, the plus sign, it'll be like right here, and you're gonna go to join channel, okay? So you want to use join channel. So I am gonna also do this here. So join channel. Now it'll ask you, okay, which channel you want to join. So I created a channel for each section. So if you just start searching for Start 2023, for example, if this is statistics or whichever course you're taking with me, you should already see some of the sections. If you do not know which section, you can go to Canvas. And in Canvas, it'll show which section of my class you're taking. So, for example, this is section 16. And this is what you want to join. Okay, so let's say I want to join this channel. So I'll just click on join. So we will be using this channel for multiple purposes. First of all, we will be using it in order for you to know how to join exam or office hours. So let's say you are on your phone. You want to go ahead and join my office hours. So you're going to go to our channel, and you will see that the message is pinned on like right here, and then you could just click on the link and that'll take you straight to the exam or straight to the office hours, depending on what is it you want. Okay, so that's number one. Number two, you can ask general questions. So let me just maximize this so you can see how many options you have here. So first of all, you can just type pure and simple text, but you can also add emojis. There are a ton of them here. You can add GIFs, whatever you want. You can attach a file here if you want to. You can also format it if you want, like add a link, stuff like that. You can actually attach a voice message or even a video message, but I think it limits to the, like the size of the video has to be pretty small. But let's say you just have a general question and you want to ask everyone, right? So you're going to say, for example, can I use calculator, my own calculator for exams? Okay, so this is my question. Now, you have an option of scheduling this message for later. So if you were to go over here, you can schedule it. So for example, you want to schedule it in the morning and not on Saturday or whatever. So that's an option. But let's say I don't want to schedule it. I just want to send it right now. So I'll go ahead and send it. So another person can answer, or I can answer here. Now you can use a threaded reply. So if I just answer right here in the channel, so I'll say no, because I want everyone to use Desmos calculator, to get used to using a Desmos calculator. Okay, so let's say I'm posting that message. Okay, so Professor Lurie answered. Now, if you want to thank me for answering, please do not type thank you, okay? Because you have these reactions right here. So you can click on the little reaction and you can react like thank you or thumbs up or I like it or whatever, okay? So please do that as opposed to just say thank you. Now, in terms of threaded replies, they're right here. So if somebody wants to reply, you can click on the thread and make it an actual thread. You can say, wow, I'm kind of disappointed, whatever. Whatever, right? So you answered, okay? Answered me. So that's how we're going to communicate if it's a general question. Now, what if you have a homework question? How would you ask me that, or your classmates? Again, this goes for everyone. Everyone will see it and everybody can answer, which is the beauty of it, right? So how are you going to do that? So let's just say that you have a question on this problem. You do not know if favorite candy bar is quantitative or qualitative. You have no idea. You watch the video, but you still don't know. So what you're going to do is in Zoom, right here, do you see this? This is called the screenshot. And this is a very handy feature because once you click on it, so you click on the little screenshot, you can now highlight the portion that you want other people to see. Okay. And then you can just click capture. By the way, you can also annotate it. There are some annotation tools in there. You can add an arrow, whatever. And now you can say, can someone help me with this question? Okay, and then you can send it, right? So this appears for everyone. Everybody can see it. People can answer. Again, if you want to answer, consider using a threaded reply so that we are all organized, okay? So that will be our main channel where we're going to ask questions, answer questions, collaborate. Everybody will be able to see it. And I will usually answer within 24 hours. You can count on that. Now, one last thing I wanted to say is, let's say you want to contact me directly. Again, please do not use Canvas inbox. Please do not use email. I want you to contact me through Zoom. How do you do that? So if it's just something that is private, if it's something that other people can answer, if it's a chat thing, then put it in the main channel. But let's say it's something private that you don't want other classmates to know, then you want to send me a direct message. How do you do that? Well, you go to the plus sign and you would do exact same thing on the phone. And then you would click on new chat. And then you want to know, okay, who am I going to be chatting with? So here you have to put my name. So put Anna Luri. Okay, I should show up. So you click on me. And then you can put your message. You can say something like, I am sorry, I won't be able to make an exam appointment tomorrow because I'm very sick. You can attach a doctor's note right there by clicking on attach file, for example, and arrange for a makeup, right? So this is between me and you. And then you can send me a message and then I will answer.